Video plus determines a demand function for a new video game. D of x is the number of games sold per day, and x is the sale price in dollars. So this problem deals with the elasticity of demand, or the elasticity function. I do have another video that explains where this function comes from, but the focus of this video is to provide an additional example. With that said, let's go ahead and do a quick review. The elasticity of demand measures the sensitivity of the demand to a slight change in price. And the elasticity of demand function is this function here, the opposite of x times the derivative of the demand function divided by the demand function. We say that total revenue is increasing for x values where the elasticity is less than 1. We also say that in this case, demand is inelastic. So an increase in price will bring an increase in revenue. When the elasticity of demand is greater than 1, revenue is decreasing, and we say the demand is elastic. So an increase in price will bring a decrease in revenue. And then the ideal situation is when the elasticity is equal to 1, and this is when the revenue is maximized, and we say demand is unit elastic. So the idea here is if we have a demand function like the one we were given, at what price could we charge to maximize revenue? Notice as the price increases, the demand does drop, but somewhere in here we have an ideal price to maximize revenue. So let's go back and take a look at our problem. Here's our demand function, and here's the elasticity function. And notice how I wrote this two ways. Instead of dividing by the demand function, we could multiply by the reciprocal of the demand function. So the first question is, how many games will be sold per day if the price is $4? So for this, we don't need the elasticity function. We can just replace x with 4 in the demand function. So we'd have d of 4 is equal to the square root of 300 minus 0.5 times 4 to the third. So we'll use the calculator to evaluate this. So this means at the price of $4, we can expect to sell 17 games per day. Number two, we want to determine the elasticity function given by this equation here. And notice how I wrote it in two different forms. Let's start by writing our demand function in rational exponent form. So we could write this as 300 minus 0.5 x to the third raised to the 1/2 power. Now let's determine the derivative of the demand function. Notice we have a composite function, so u is going to be equal to 300 minus, I'm going to put 1/2 x to the third. So u prime would be negative 3/2 x squared. So the derivative of the demand function would be equal to the derivative of u to the 1/2, or 1/2 u to the negative 1/2 times u prime, negative 3/2 x squared. So notice how we have some fractions here, and that's why to determine the elasticity function, we'll use this form of the formula here. So the elasticity function is going to be equal to negative x times the derivative of the demand function, which is here, which would be negative 3x squared all over 2 times 2, that's 4. And this quantity would be to the positive 1/2 power in the denominator. Times the reciprocal of the demand function, which would be 1 all over the quantity 300 minus 0.5 x cubed to the positive 1/2 power. So let's determine this product on the next slide. So the numerator would be positive 3x cubed. The denominator would be 4 times 300 minus 0.5 x cubed to the positive 1 power, because we'd add our exponents. 1/2 plus 1/2 would be to the first power. So this is the elasticity function that will measure how sensitive the demand is to a slight change in price. So now let's take a look at the last two questions. Notice how I do have our elasticity function here in red for easy access. So step three says, evaluate the elasticity function when x is equal to $4 and interpret the results. So now we want to determine E of 4, which would be 3 times 4 to the third divided by 4 times 300 minus 0.5 times 4 to the third. And to save some time, I've already determined this value. It's approximately 0.18. So this is obviously less than 1, which means the demand is inelastic, revenue is increasing, and an increase in price will bring an increase in revenue. So from here, the last question is, what price will maximize the revenue? And revenue is maximized when the elasticity of demand is equal to 1. So to answer this question, we can set our elasticity function equal to 1 and solve for x. So we want to know when this is equal to 1, and I'm going to write 1 over 1. So to solve this, we can cross multiply. So 3x cubed must equal 4 times the quantity 300 minus 0.5x cubed. So we'll go ahead and distribute the 4 here. We'll have 3x cubed equals 1200 minus 2x cubed. Now we'll add 2x cubed to both sides, so we'll have 5x cubed equals 1200. Divide both sides by 5. So we have x cubed is equal to 240, which means x is equal to the cube root of 240. And again, to save some time, I've already determined what this would be. X is approximately equal to 6.21, which means the ideal price to maximize revenue, if this is the demand function, would be $6.21. Let's go and take a look at where this price is on the graph. $6.21 would be approximately in here. And based upon this demand function, this is the price that would maximize revenue. I hope you found this example helpful.